Sweden. It's the Electric Boys!
Mary and the Mystery One. I'm right here, right now. I've got Connie. I've got Niklas from main band of the evening, the Electric Boys. Nice to see you, chaps.
Nice to see you too.
And the interesting thing about your band that I find is that you have a real kind of blend of different styles. You're obviously basically a rock orientated band, but there's kind of, you know, there's a touch of the old Hendrix style. There's a touch of Beatles in there. I think your drumming really reminds me of John Bonham, that Led Zeppelin kind of punch, you know? Well, you've got the bass drums as well, haven't you?
Yeah.
You know?
Two of them as well.
Yeah, I know. Is it something that just comes out of the four guys, it kind of makes a big mix, or is it something you work on?
No, we haven't worked on that. I mean, Connie comes down with a riff or whatever and we start playing, and that's about it. That is the mixture of the band. I mean, the chemistry of the guys together.
There's so many different inspirations, like you said, you know, different inspiration sources, and when it's mixed together, that's that's what we're all about, I think. We like a lot of stuff in the 60s, and like, especially me, and I'm into pop stuff from the 60s, you know. And we like all the hard rock bands from the 70s, basically. And now that it's 92, and I don't know, it's just a combination of lots of things.
Yeah, you just bring them all together to make one great whole, eh?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Now, I know that you were actually originally signed for your worldwide deal from America, is that right?
Yeah.
Does that cause you any problems in terms of just the communication and dealing with a record company that's so far away from where you live?
Yeah, expensive phone bills.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And have to have tons of gears all over the place. So.
We got, just to make it easier, we got two different back lines, one for Europe and one for America.
So you just keep one over there all the time?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's the easiest way.
Yeah, it kind of makes a lot of sense, doesn't it?
Yeah, in the end anyway.
But I know you're going to be using your European back line very shortly, aren't you? Because once the album's out, which is on May 25, I believe, you're going to be off and doing the European tour, some Scandinavian dates, some UK dates, and possibly some other stuff, yeah?
Yep. We'll be here at the end of June for about, I don't know, two or three weeks. The more the better, really.
I presume that's, you're like most rock bands in that you like being out and playing live, yeah, rather than just, you know, sitting in the studio for months on end.
Yeah.
Especially after, I mean, we haven't toured for, I don't know, it's a long time. We've been in the studio and
it
having
has been
a good time.
It has been a long time, because look, this beard has grown since I last saw you.
Yeah.
Especially this nice bit here. What's going on here with this?
I don't know. It's a long time to explain.
Yeah, it's a long story.
You have time for that?
Yeah, go on, tell me.
Okay, I cut it off.
I reckon it's about time we went and checked out the third and final track from Sweden's Electric Boys. This is off their first album, and it's called All Lips and Hips.
Now take this.
She is so alright.
Sweden's finest right here in London. That is the Electric Boys. Good night.